Ahluwalia, and I recently got recommended from 4FSB Varanasi, which was actually my first attempt at SSB. And now talking about my whole involvement and my process. So firstly, I would start off with thanking to the Cavalier, to the all the teachers that we had here at Cavalier, and the guidance that they gave me throughout the process, and even all the other students on how to go through the process, how to tackle a situation or a particular task that we had to face. More importantly, the basic understanding of it is the whole evaluation is based upon us, how we are reacting to a particular situation, or what would our solution be, and everything, our participation. It is they can here at Cavalier, you would be easily able to know how you have to tackle a situation, but eventually it depends upon how practical your solutions are. So starting off with my experience at the SSB, the first day in my screening round, I was easily able to narrate my lecture to the people. And in the GD group, wherein there were 15 students, there was actually a whole lot of mess created, and there were students who were misguiding the whole conversation. But I stick to my points. And I made sure of the fact that I presented my own points very effectively, and I spoke only when it was needed, or to count on the group whenever it was needed. So then I got screened in, and after that, starting from the next day, the firstly we had a psychology test. In the psychology test, I actually personally to me did a very good job, and all of that credit, most of the credit actually goes to Dutt sir in here, because he actually taught us very well on how to attempt those psychology tests, and the importance of the psychology tests as well. Because for me as a candidate, I have understand the importance of psychology tests on a whole. So it is actually very important, and I personally think that it was one of the most interesting parameters that we had to face in there in the SSB. So the first day we had our psychology test in the morning. And then after that, on that day, I didn't have anything scheduled. For the next day, I had my interview scheduled, wherein actually I prepared all the interview questions that we were told here at Cavalier. Also, the basic fact that the interview mostly is dependent on us. So it depends on how we are tackling the situation, how we are answering the questions. And obviously, the interview would also cross-question you if he has to, on what your answers to a particular situation. So again, it is upon you how your friends are, or what your experience has been overall. So everything again, my interview went on for what, around an hour or so, in which I was asked all the different questions serial wise, and I was able to mostly answer them. Also, there were in the last 10 or 15 minutes, there were questions asked to me about the international current affairs, all my views upon the farmer laws and everything. And yet again, I was prepared about that, and I was able to easily answer them. Since I was appearing for the Air Force entry, I was also asked basic questions about the Air Force. So I answered, so I had prepared that as well, the basic commands, and who is the commander in chief right now, the different ranks of officers and non-commissioned officers, everything. So I had learned, and I was able to answer that. So the interview ended that day. So next day we had our GTO sessions. In the GTO sessions, I can very well say that it actually depends upon our group, and I had the privilege or the good fortunes that I actually had a very good group, wherein we were very well able to tackle all the situations effectively and not create a huge mess. We were actually able to go through all of the tasks that we had. And even in the GTO, one clear thing that I remember was our GTO sir told us that it is a combination of 10 different tasks. So in those 10 different tasks, it doesn't depend on if you are not able to perform in any one of them. It depends upon your overall experience and your performance in that. So that was very important to me, wherein personally I was not able to perform up to my marks in the individual rounds, but I covered it up and performed to my best in the other rounds, like the command task and everything. So I really think that helped me in during my GTO. And again, the group is actually very important. And lastly, in the conference, I was basically asked about how my whole experience was and if any changes were to be made to the SSB Center, which I just declined. And I thanked them and they thanked me for being there. And then afterwards, when the results were announced, I got recommended. So there were 55 students who were screened in the first day, and out of which 7 were recommended at the final day in the conference, wherein 5 of them were freshers and 2 of them were repeaters. So out of the 5 of us who were freshers, there were 4 amongst ourselves who were also appearing for flying. So we had to wait another day after filling the forms in the conference round to appear for CPSS, wherein we gave our CPSS the next day, starting off with the cognitive rounds. And then next was our gaming rounds, wherein we were made to sit in a cockpit and had some controls in which we had to play some games. It was most of it was dependent on our motor capability in there. So I was able to clear that as well. And now I'll have my medicals in March. Thank you so much.